Good day to our instructor, Mrs. Concepcion Carapas. I am Kyra Altea BAC, and for this demo, I will be teaching grade 4, and our topic is all about two kinds of nouns.
And I am Angeline D. Hulaton. I will be teaching grade 5, and our topic is all about simple present tense of verbs.
At the end of the class, the grade 4 students will be able to identify the proper and common nouns and give the importance of proper and common nouns to everyday life.
And my objective is identify the present tense of verb in a sentence, use simple present tense of verb in a sentence correctly, and give the importance of simple present tense.
Everyone, let us all stand for our prayer. Michelle, can you lead the prayer for our blessed now?
God, thank you for today. Please guide our teachers for speaking.
Okay, you may now sit. Good morning, grade 4 students.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, grade 5.
Good morning, ma'am.
Okay, so I will check the attendance. Say present if you hear your name. Isabel Nakar.
Present, ma'am.
Lara Nazarita.
Present, ma'am.
Joan Sampag.
Present, ma'am.
Okay, for grade 5, say present if you hear your name. Faye.
Yes, ma'am.
Rochelle.
Present, ma'am.
Maylene.
Present, ma'am.
And Princess.
Present, ma'am.
Okay, so before we discuss our new lesson for today, let us first review what have we tackled last meeting. So what was our lesson last meeting? Okay, Isabel.
Our lesson last meeting is noun.
Okay, so again, noun refers to a person, thing, place, event, animals, plants, or any forms of nature. So, Joan, give me an example of name of a person.
Maria.
Okay, very good. Next, Lara, give me one example of eating.
Ball.
Very good. Isabel, give me one example of event you attended.
Disneyland Beach.
Okay. Next. Again, Isabel, give me two examples of animals.
Dog and cat picture.
Okay, very good. And Johan, give me two examples of plants you have in your backyard. Okay, thank you. So class, here's the dialogue of Anna and her mother about their visit to her grandparents in Manila. I want you to read it silently, and later on I will call two pupils to read it in front.
Okay, now, what about our topic last meeting, class? Yes, Princess?
Last meeting, we discussed about bird.
Very good. And who can define bird? Can you raise your hand if you want to answer, please? Okay, Rochelle?
Bird is an action word of state of being.
Very good. And what are the two types of bird? Yes.
Linking verb and action verb.
Okay. So what is linking verb? Yes, Princess?
Linking verb connects the subject to the information about it. There is no action involved in it.
Okay, very well said. Now, can you give me two examples of linking verb? Rochelle?
Is, are, have.
Okay, it's correct. How about action verb? Yes.
Action verb describes the action of a subject or the doing verb.
Can you give me two examples of action verb, Princess?
Walking, singing, and dancing.
Right, very good.
so Lara and Isabel, please go in front. So Lara, you will be reading the dialogue of Anna, and Isabel, you will be reading the dialogue of Manu. Okay, you may start.
I'm so excited to see Lolo and Lola.
Me too. There are also many places in Manila.
Really, Mommy? What are those places?
On our way, we'll pass by Alabang, Sugat, Taguig, Makati, and Pasay.
Are there big malls and buildings there?
Of course, there are plenty of them in Manila. There's also what they call Manila Zoo. Would you like to visit it?
Yes, Mommy.
Okay then, we will go tomorrow together with Lola and Lola.
Okay, very good. Let's give them a 5 claps. Okay, so who are the characters mentioned in the dialogue?
Anna and Molly.
Okay, next. What are the places they will pass by on their way to Manila? Raise your hand if you want to answer. Okay, Lara.
The place that they will be set.
Okay, that's right.
Before we move in our new lesson, so kakanta tayo, okay?
Okay, teacher, so
ito yung lyrics na kanta na kakantahin natin. So, ganito siya. So, tayo. Sasabayan naman natin yung kanta.
Now, who wants to come in front and underline the nouns with or present in the answers written on the board. So number one, hey Lara, please look away in front and tell your guys. Okay, correct. Thank you. Next, Johan, please answer number two. Correct. Thank you. Last, Sabel, can you answer the last number? Also correct. Thank you. You all got the correct answer. So, what did you notice about these underlined words?
Starts with capital letters while others starts with small letters.
Very good. Are these words considered nouns?
Yes, teacher.
That's correct. So why do you think that these words are nouns? Okay, Clara?
Because the underlined words are name of the person and places.
Yes, very good. Very good. It seems like you really understand what the noun is.
So, now, our topic is all about simple present tense of verb. Can you read what does it mean, Alisa?
Expresses habitual actions, present state, or a condition, future actions, and general things, or facts.
So, it means simple present tense is expressed as habitual action, present state, or condition, then future actions, and general things, or facts. So, simple present tense, it is the action is done by regularly or repeatedly. Or the action is done in the present time, like today or now. So, in using the simple present tense, there are a few rules to follow. First one is when our subject is singular, then we will add s or es to our verb. So, for example, singular or plural?
Singular.
Singular. ano tayong tinatawag na? Habitual actions. Simple present tense express habitual action, present state, or condition, future action, and general verb or past. So, what is habitual action? Can you read this, Alisa?
Habitual action, used to refer to the repeated or regular actions, and it is usually used with adverbs. Always, usually, often, normally, sometimes, occasionally, seldom, or rarely, never, and time, expressions such as all the time, every now and then, once or twice a week.
So, meron tayong example. She usually go to the bed at 10 o'clock in the morning. So, ano yung correct na gagamitin natin dyan? May goals, very good. Next, present state or conditions. So, says here that we use verbs to express the present conditions or state of the subject. For example, the Lord hears our prayer. Kasi nga, di ba, similar lang yung ating subject. So, gagamitan namin siya ng verb. Mag-a-add lang tayo ng S. Another example, she belongs to the first group. Then, future action. We use verb to express the action that is happening in the near future. Yeah. For example, the plane arrives at 10 p.m. Kasi similar lang yung ating subject. Another one, the birthday party starts at 9 o'clock in the morning. So, general truth or fact. We use verbs to express the truth or fact information about the subject. For example, God loves us unconditionally. Another, the moon shines at night. Yeah. So, naintindihan niyo ba?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, so our review lesson for today is all about two kinds of nouns. Which is the common nouns and proper nouns. So, do you have any idea about these two? Okay, none. So, common noun. It's a general, non-specific term for a person, place, things, animals. Usually, common nouns are not capitalized unless they start a sentence. While proper noun is a specific, unique name of person, place, thing, animal. Unlike common nouns, proper nouns are almost always capitalized whether they start a sentence or not. So, I have here an example. So in our first column, we have the common nouns, and for the second column, we have the proper nouns. So we have the four categories here, names of animals, names of place, and names of person. So when you say common nouns, it is general term. So for verb is a general term, and if we say proper noun, we will use a specific name of the animal. So, when you say bird, eagle is a specific name because proper noun refers to a specific term or unique term for the names of nouns. So, can you give me another example of proper noun of bird? So, for example, eagle. What other kinds of birds do you know? Okay, parrot, that's correct. So next is fish. We have the proper noun is milkfish or bangus in Tagalog. siya. Hindi siya general term. And next is mall. Oh, madami ding mall. We have here the Nepo Mall, Pesta Mall. Tapos, meron SMs and Brother Sons. School. Okay, syempre marami namang school. Iba't ibang pangalan. And country, of course. Madami tayong country dito sa Pilipinas. And marami din sa Asia. And lastly, name of person. So, kung sinabing president, hindi lang naman isa yung president, di ba? Sa iba't ibang country, marami tayo. So, pag sinabi talaga proper noun, is specific kung siya gagamitin sa isang sentence. Hindi siya general term like singer, actress, ganito. And sabi pa doon sa definition niya is, pag common nouns, nag-start siya sa small letters unless nasa-umpisahan siya ng isang sentence. And pag proper nouns naman, lagi siya nag-umpisa sa big letters. Okay. So,
so, I read four sentences in the board. You will give the simple present tense of the verb in the underline. So raise your hand if you want to answer, class. Number one, who wants to answer? Kay Alisa.
The earth lying around the sun.
So, yes, that's correct. Love your hand. Number two, yes, Rochelle.
My friends arrive at 9 a.m.
So, what's the answer?
Arrive.
Yes, that's correct. Number three, yes, Alisa.
She blank in Manila. The answer is please.
Correct. And the last one, yes.
Angel brush or brushes her teeth twice a day.
So what's the answer?
Brushes.
Yes. Great. Very good. All your answers are correct.
So I listed three common nouns in the board. Now give the proper nouns which counterpart to its common noun. So for number one, Nala, can you answer number one? Number two, Joanne, and number three, Isabel. Very good. All your answers are correct. Now, who can tell me the difference between common noun and proper noun? Isabel?
Teacher, proper noun is specific names of person, places, things, and animals, while common noun is the general names of person, places, things, and animals.
Okay, very well said. What else? Hey, Lala.
Common nouns begin with a small letter unless they start a sentence where proper nouns are almost always start in capital letters, whether they begin a sentence or not.
Very good. So why the use of proper noun and common noun is very important in our everyday life? Joanne?
Because we cannot determine the specific and general names of a person, places, things, and animals.
That's right. Very good. What else? Isabel?
It is important because we don't know if we need to write the word or noun in the small letter or in capital letter.
Very good. All your answers are correct.
So, what are the four uses of simple present tense? Anyone? Yes?
Habitual action, present state, or condition. Future action and general groups or fox teacher.
Okay, that's correct. So now, class, why do you think the simple present tense of the verb is important to us?
so that we will later compose correct grammar in speaking already.
Yes, that's correct. So, kailangan natin matutunan ang simple present tense verb para magamit natin siya sa tamang grammar. Hindi naman pwedeng pag ating subject ay plural, then mag-add pa rin tayo na E-R-E-S sa ating verb, di ba? So, naintindihan niyo ba?
Yes, teacher.
Any questions?
None.
Okay. So, where are you going?
Activity.
Yan. Directions. Select the correct simple present tense of verb inside the parentheses to complete the sentence. So, sagutan niyo lang sa papel.
To evaluate if you have really understand our lesson for today, get a piece of paper and answer the activity written on the board. Write your answers correct. Write your answers only. So I will give you 5 minutes to do that. And later on, I will give your assignment.
Are you done with 5 o'clock? So now, malaman natin sa talagang naisigyan nyo, okay? Huwag ang read number 1. So, check din natin yung paper. Yes, Rochelle?
If love is our very hot outside.
So, what's the correct answer?
It is very hot outside.
Very good. Number 2. Nakuha niyo ba?
Yes, teacher.
Yan. So, number 2. The wedding ceremony, long start or starts?
Starts.
Great. The wedding ceremony starts at 8 o'clock in the morning. Number 3. Cuts, long, cutches or cuts? Cut, cut, and mice. Number 4. Jeremy and Althea, love or loves?
Love.
Bakit loves?
Kasi plural.
Yes, they?
Plural.
Then number 5. They always love, tell or tells?
Tells.
Bakit tell?
Kasi plural.
Yeah. Then number 6. My friends and I blank like our lives. My friends and I like to spend the afternoon playing outside. Then number 7. Their blank is or are?
Is.
So there is. There is an annual basketball tournament in the barangay. Number 8. A usual glass, go or goes?
Go.
Yan. Then number 9. Sometimes, please blank one or one.
One.
One. Bakit one?
Singular.
Then number 10, marshmallows is or R?
R.
Bakit R? So marshmallows is short. Yeah. So nanakuha niyo ba class? Wow, you got perfect. So clap your hands. So are you done with your activity?
Yes.
You can pass your papers. Okay. So pass your paper to the second record. Thank you. So for your assignment, you will write in one full sheet of paper. I will dictate it. So, please copy your assignment. List down at least 5 wishes for your coming birthday that you want to receive. Apply the proper usage of common and proper noun or using capital and small letters at the beginning of the words or names of person, place, things, and animals. So, if you are done, please stand up. Now stand up. Thank you for listening. Have a nice day and ingat kayo sa pag-uwi. So, thank you, class. Have a